What's going on, everyone? Hopefully you're all having a great day. Today we're going to talk about a free mod that goes along with the FA-18C module inside DCS, and that's the Chiller Juice Super Hornet mod. This not only comes with the EA-18G Growler, but the Echo and Foxtrot variants as well. Quick tips on how to get by Mega Upload's 5GB daily limit to ensure that you can get this mod free and on the same day you download it with some liveries that were a little tricky to get to show up in the game, but we'll get you through it. So without wasting too much time, let's get into it. So we're back in the official DCS World forum here, and we can see that we have the Chill the Juice Super Hornet Community Mod version 2.1. I'll go ahead and I'll include a link in the description so it's easy to follow along, but once we're here, we want to go ahead down to the download and click on it. We can see that it brings us to the Mega Upload site, where we just have to wait for it to decrypt before we can get into it. Now, like I said in the beginning, there's a 5GB daily limit for Mega Upload in regards to free downloads. And we can see that the skin pack is already well over 5 gigs, and that's not even including the mods that we want. But we also want to have a few liveries to play around with when we get the mod, so we're going to go ahead and we're going to right click and we're going to open the skin pack. And in here we can see that we're presented with a bunch of different skins in a list. And for this, we're just going to go ahead and we're going to right click on Benny's. We're going to download, and we're going to download it as a zip. If we download it as a standard, it would download 14 individual files. But it's nice and neat. If we download it as a zip, it'll just keep it into one. So we'll go ahead and we'll do that. From there, we're going to take our mouse. We're going to go up to the back icon in our browser. Gets us back to this menu. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to select all three of these files. Once I've done that, I'm going to right click. We're going to go to download. Now here I like to standard download because they're already in zips. So there's no need for us to download all three of them together. We can download all three of them individually. So we'll go ahead and we'll go to standard. You can see that it's added it to this list down here. Now this does take quite a bit of time. The download varies from what I found. Omega upload it varies quite high and quite low. This can go as high as, you know, depending on what your internet is. I've seen this for myself go as high as 30. I've also seen it come down for no reason to go as low as, you know, 200, 300 kilobytes a second. So take it with a grain of salt. We'll just have to wait for it to finish. But shouldn't take too long, and once it finishes, we'll come back. So you can see that we've completed the download. Now that that's completed, they've put all the files in our download folder. So we'll go ahead and we'll look at how we actually install the mod. So we're in our downloads folder here, and we can see all the things that we've downloaded: Benny skins, the mod, the tanker mod, and the SRS fix. So we'll go ahead. The first thing I like to do is to pull all these files out. So we'll go ahead and we'll copy Benny skins. We'll bring it onto our desktop. And it'll take a little bit, because it's a pretty big file. But this allows us to access all the files inside it. We'll go ahead and run the Super Hornet mod. And right-click copy. Paste. When that's done, we'll go back and we'll grab the tanker. We'll drag it. And you can see how that dragging it is also copy. So, clicking and dragging, or right-clicking, copying, pasting. Is the same. So, whatever your preference. And that's all three over there. So now that we've done that, we're going to go ahead and we're going to open up our Super Hornet mod folder. And we can see that we have a README file. We'll go ahead and we'll give that a quick read. You guys could read this on your own. It's very nice to go through. It just talks about kind of the module and the guys that kind of built in everything else like that. But we're looking for the install, so we'll go down here. After downloading the mod and liveries from here, if you wish, back up the F18C core mods and mods folders inside program files equal dynamics DCS world open beta. We are on the Steam version, so our pathing will be a little bit different, but we are going to do that because I always recommend backing up all your original files before you add on a mod. Just to make sure if there's any issues with the mod and the way it interacts with your PC, you have the original files that you can always revert back to, just in case there's an incident. After that, drag and drop the three folders inside the mod download. We'll be greeted with a pop-up asking if we want to replace the files. We will select yes, and that should be it. Then we'll just have to install the liveries. So we'll go through that real quick. Now the first thing I like to do is I like to have a shortcut. As you can see here, I have two shortcuts on my desktop. I have one for DCS World, which brings me right into the pathing for my program files. And I also have one for the save games. That brings me into my save games folder. So we will go ahead and we'll see how we do that real quick. On the desktop, you right click, go to new, go to shortcut, Once you're greeted here, go to Browse. It brings up this menu, and this is where we're going to select where our DCS is located. So for me, this PC, C, Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, DCS World, and that's it. Okay. You're going to see that it has the path here. We're going to go ahead and click Next. Because I already have minus DCS World, it's going to put a 2. And we can see now that with this shortcut, we are in exactly where we want to be. Now if we go ahead and do the same thing for our save games, New, Shortcut, Browse, this PC, C, Users, Me, Save Games, and DCS. Now don't worry about this if you're on the open beta. I am on the open beta, but it still just has it as a DCS folder. I think that's just the way Steam classifies it, but it does work in the open beta as well. So again, click OK. Next, DCS, but we want this one saved games. And again, because I've already done it, I'll give it 2. Finish. We can see that if we open this up, it brings us to our... Oh, I clicked the wrong one. Save games. It brings us to our save games inside DCS. So now we can go to that DCS World folder that we just created and start the backup process. I like to back up all my stuff up on a different drive, but you guys do what works best for you. Just be careful if you're backing up on the same drive, it can tend to eat up space fairly quickly. The two things that we're concerned about here are both labeled FA18C, but they're in the core mods and the mods folder. So just make sure you know where each one's coming from. And we'll go ahead and we'll start here with core mods, aircraft, FA18C. And we'll go ahead and we'll copy that. And like I said, I've created these folders in a different location, but for the sake of this video, we'll open that up and we'll just paste it in our core mods so we know that this one came from core mods and it's going in core mods. We'll just wait for that to finish. Come out of here, back into our backup, and we'll come out of here back into DCS. We'll go into mods now, aircraft, and again FA18C. We'll copy this, and we'll go into mods, and we'll paste it in mods. Yes. And now we are ready to install the mod. So we can go back into the Super Hornet mod folder. And from the readme from earlier, the three folders that it told us to copy was Bizarre, Core Mods, and Mods. So we'll go ahead and we'll select all three. I haven't experimented with the scripts yet. I'm sure there's probably a couple of you guys that have. I think it's for the jamming capabilities of the Growler. Like I said, I haven't fully experimented with it yet. But if you guys want to, feel free. I would just recommend that you back up those as well. So for this, we're going to go ahead and we're going to copy. And over here in our DCS... we're going to go ahead and we're going to paste. When it asks us to copy over, we're going to say yes. The Super Hornet is now installed. We'll go ahead and we'll do liveries real quick. Now we can go ahead and put the liveries on. We'll go ahead and tip any skins. And we can see that we have the Echo, Foxtrot, and Growler versions. We'll go ahead and start with the Growler. We get a quick install guide. It says that we can put it back in that core mod folder that we had it from earlier, or the save games folder. I prefer to put it in the save games, so that's what we're going to go ahead and do. The liveries EA-18G. Now what that means is it doesn't mean this folder. We double-click this folder, double-click this folder, and these are the skins that we want. So we'll go ahead and we'll copy these. We'll go into our save games DCS. You can see I don't have a liveries folder right now, so we'll go ahead and we'll make one. New folder, liveries. And it was inside that, it was EA18G. We'll go ahead and we'll paste. We'll go back into Penny's for the Echo and Foxtrot versions. Echo. Again, drill down through these. Through this to these. Copy. Back into our liveries. We're going to make a new folder. This one is going to be FA18Echo. Cap locks is on. Echo. And we'll put those in there. Go back. Bennies. And we'll grab the Foxtrots. Copy. Liveries. New. FA18F. Paste. Done. That should be all three variants installed with liveries. And why not, we'll look at the Superbug AI tanker real quick. Open up the README. Where are we putting this? Manual install. Move aircraft folder into save games. Again, open beta mods slash aircraft. Let's go ahead. We'll copy this. Save games, like it said. Mods. Aircraft. I already have it installed, but we'll paste it. Yes. Again, it wouldn't be there for you. Or if you maybe don't have this folder yet because you don't have mods, you can go ahead from here, make a mods folder, make an aircraft folder, and drop it in there. But let's go ahead and game and test this out. So we're in game right now. You can already see that it worked because it's changed our menu. If we had the FA-18C menu selected, this is what the new one's going to look like with the mod. We'll go ahead in Mission Editor and we'll hop in one of these planes. So we're in the Mission Editor now. I just picked Batumi. We see that we got three jets already. And if we click on one, see that's the FA-18F. And if we look at the list now, we've got the option of the Growler, the normal Hornet, the Echo Super Hornet, and the F Super Hornet. We'll go ahead and we'll add the Growler. Growler. Click on it here. Ramp. If we click on it, we see that we got the liveries installed. We can go ahead and add some cool things to the pylons. Do our jamming pods. Right, you do a bunch of different things. Keep it like that for now. Keep this nice and short. Foxtrot. Right, and there's a lot more skins, guys, right? Like, you can go back to the mega upload 24 hours later, get the rest of those skins. There was a lot of skins in that pack that we also didn't install. This is just a normal Hornet. You can see that's unaffected by installing this mod. We can get in that one, no problem. The one thing that I will say is that this will not pass the integrity check. Last that I heard, because it is affecting the way the game sees the mod. But so that's a little bit unfortunate for those that are on multiplayer. But you can go ahead, and I mean, you can just, if you're planning to play on multiplayer, you can take these files out. If you're planning on playing solo, go ahead and drop them back in. And that's a way that you can kind of just quickly get this module back in and out of DCS. But we'll go ahead and game real quick. So we're back in game now. You can see that we've spawned in the Growler. Display is a little bit different. All they've done really is just masked kind of digital display over top of the game display, so it does look a little bit weird when it is on, but you know, there we can see the Echo right beside us getting ready to take out. Normal Hornet on the other side. Go ahead and we'll cycle through. There's us in the Growler. Echo. Foxtrot. And our normal Hornet. Hop back in. And as far as I can tell, everything works. I haven't spent a lot of time in it. Spent a few hours kind of messing around with it. But yeah, as far as I can tell, everything works. A few things that are different. I believe it's on the F version. You cannot get the lower fuel tank because of the way they've done the cockpit. This one as well, I don't think you can get the lower fuel tank. But yeah, overall, it's a pretty decent mod. I like it. It's going to add to me in the future, doing some different cinematic content, more modern day missions, jamming, that kind of thing. So definitely recommend it if you guys are F-18 Super Hornet fans. It was definitely a cool free mod to have. But with that being said, I hope you guys have a great day. Thanks for watching, and take care.